Welcome back, sir. Boss?
Do you mind? I'm trying to have a good time here.
I think you'll want to see this.
Are you crazy? Bringing a stick of dynamite into my club?
That's just it, boss. It's all over the place. I think our speakeasy arsonist is getting ready to strike again.
What's it gonna take to get Trixie to squeal on Kid? Hey,
what?
Do you know what happened to Trixie out there? She seems pretty freaked out.
You talk weird, you know that? But no, I don't know nothing about Trixie's emotional state. Kid doesn't pay me nearly enough to pour drinks and babysit his crazy girlfriends.
I'll have a drink.
What's your poison?
Pepsi. On second thought, forget it.
Suit yourself.
So everyone in the Wall of Fame are enemies of Kid Tannen that have coincidentally been killed?
Enemies, rivals, guys who looked at Trixie the wrong way. Yeah.
Talk to you later.
Hey, look, a paying customer.
I don't think they'd be interested in my caricature. I always wanted to be famous. Not a pretty bunch. Nah. You think you could draw a picture of this guy?
Sure. Hey, that looks like that Artie McFly think.
I never noticed that before. Hey, can you give him a hat like Artie wears?
Voila!
Nice job.
Now, go tell them chumps at the New Yorker.
Sorry about this, Dad. Not a pretty bunch. Trixie?
Yeah?
About Artie McFly.
Him. Have you heard from him? Is he okay?
I think something bad might have happened to him.
What? You mean Kid went back on his promise?
Yeah, that's right.
Oh no! Oh, poor Artie! Poor sweet little Artie!
I know.
That rattlesnake Kid! He can't get away with this!
You gonna turn over the evidence you got against him?
Am I ever? Just watch me! Wait a minute. What evidence do you have that Kid bumped Artie off?
It's just a hunch.
Keep your hunches for the racetrack. It ain't nice to get a girl all worked up over unsubstantiated rumors.
I talked to Kid.
Oh?
He told me about Artie.
Oh.
It was awesome of you to plead for his life.
And it was awesome of Kid to spare it. So you see why I gotta get rid of all the dirt I got on Kid. As long as he's loyal to me, I gotta stay loyal to him.
I don't know how to tell you this, but I think you should check out the Wall of Fame.
Why? What is it? Artie! I don't believe it! We had a deal! Artie was supposed to be safe!
I don't know what to say.
Well, I do. Felony tax evasion.
What?
Before he died, Artie was teaching me about all sorts of stuff. Literature, history, accounting. And I made a big discovery while I was copying all of Kid's books. This establishment ain't entirely on the up and up.
Really?
Oh, I knew about all the gangster stuff. That kind of thing you expect from tough guys like Kid. But when I found out he ain't been paying taxes on his speakeasy profits, well, cheating Uncle Sam is one step over the line. Once I turn this over to the police, they'll throw the book at him. This book! Hey, copper! What happened to my louse of an ex-boyfriend?
I don't know.
Rats. I told the chief we need a team of bloodhounds like they got over in Placerville. Yeah, but in the meantime...
All right, everyone. Party's over. Everyone out of the speakeasy.
Speakeasy? You're mistaken, officer. This is an ice cream parlor.
Nice try, you. Out!
Callahan. Would the Valenti mob be willing to help, defuse this little situation?
Sure, no problem. I'll bring it up in the next, company meeting.
Hey, we ain't begging here. Kid just thought JJ might like a piece of the action. Especially now that he's just caught the speakeasy arsonist.
Wait, you mean... Doc?
Doc? You ain't with the Valenti gang at all, are you? What do you know about the arsonist?
Come on, you. Off to the station house.
Kid's gonna get you, rat. He's gonna get all of you.
Yeah, yeah. Well, that's that. Thanks to Miss Trotter's evidence, the entire Hill Valley police force is out looking for Kid and his goons.
You don't understand. We've got to find him now. He's captured a friend of mine.
Who?
Never mind.
Don't worry. We've got the entire town square sealed off. If Tannen's within a mile of here, we'll find him eventually.
I don't think we have time for eventually. Hey boy, how you doing? Good dog. The only thing I want to break this bottle on is one of those goons' heads. I don't think so. Parker must have confiscated this hooch from the speakeasy. Parker must have confiscated this hooch from the speakeasy. Ew. Irving Kid Tannen. Guess he dropped this on his way out. It's empty. Figures. Hey, Einy, get your nose over here. All right. I really don't think Tannen and Doc are with Herbert Hoover, Einy. Okay, I'll check it out. A button. All right, Doc, here I come.
Callahan, what are you doing here?
Never
mind. Come here and help me get rid of this stinking arsonist.
Edna?
I caught her planting dynamite while he was clearing out the soup kitchen. Guess Sagan was innocent after all.
I was researching a story, you ignoramus!
Tell it to St. Peter, sister.
Hey, what's all this?
Parker?
Tannen, you're under arrest.
Get him, Sacramento boy.
I can't do that, kid.
What? Oh, I get it.
Why don't you let go of Miss Strickland and call it a night?
Hey, look over there!
Watch out!
Give it up, Tannen. The alley's blocked off and so are the roads out of town. It's over.
Over? Nothing is over until Kid Tannen says it's over.
Make it easy on yourself, Tannen.
Tannens never make things easy.
He's not about to let me in.
Take that, copper! No one messes with Kid Tannen!
Want your flashback, Tannen? Come again! The only thing I want to break this bottle on is one of those goons' heads.
Come on. Come on, kid. You know how this'll end.
Yeah, with me dancing on your grave.
It's empty, so what's the point?
Tannen! Make like a tree and die, rat! Are you shooting at me? Are you shooting at me? Whoa!
Bowling for 10. You want your flashback, Tannen? Come and get it! Trail of explosive booze, leading right into the garage.
Make it easy on yourself. Of Tannen?
Tannens never make... make things easy.
Hey, there's an idea. But not while Edna's in there. Thank you. A trail of explosive booze leading right into the garage. Hey, kid!
Eat lead, phony! No one messes—
Hey, moron!
Moron, this!
Go, Tannen!
Make like a tree and die, rat! Hey!
Atta girl.
Come on, kid. You know how this'll end.
Hey, kid!
Eat lead, phony! Are you shooting at me? Are you shooting at me?
Hey, kid.
That ain't a real gun.
Oh, right. I forgot. I better just get rid of it then.
Oh, crap.
Hey, he's getting away.
Oh, no.
Yes.
No.
There. Good as new.
Oh, look, Tannen.
The judge's son. All right, Parker. I want a getaway car and a clear road to Nevada, or the brown kid gets it.
Doc.
Marty.
Doc?
Yes, it's me.
I'm talking to you through the radio apparatus my younger self has installed in the rocket car. What's going on up there?
It's not good, Doc. Trixie and Parker did their part, but now Kid's holding you hostage.
Great Scott!
No kidding.
Try to get Kid in the car. Once he's inside, give me a signal, and I'll do the rest.
How am I?
You!
Emmett!
You're the cause of all of this, ain't you? I should have known. You don't look like any Callahan I ever seen.
Yeah.
No one makes a fool out of me, you backstabbing twerp! Got any— Hey! Doc, hit it!
Irving Tannen, I'm placing you under arrest for kidnapping, attempted murder, tax evasion, and smelling like a piece of crap.
Tax evasion?
Haven't you heard? The feds are practically drooling over Trixie's books.
Trixie?
That's what you get for killing Artie, you bastard!
What? I didn't...
Trixie?
Artie?
All right, Grandpa.
My poor car.
I believe I owe you an apology, Mr. Brown. Thanks to your ridiculous contraption, Hill Valley's most notorious criminal is finally headed to prison.
No apologies necessary, Miss Strickland. My rocket car may have accidentally saved the day, but only because it's a completely out-of-control failure. I need a new idea.
If you're willing to listen, I might have a few suggestions.
But first, I think we should take in a movie.
I'm all yours, Mr. Brown.
I think you'll like it. It's all about a brilliant scientist with an overabundance of hubris.
Whew. Come on, Einie. Let's go find Doc. Thanks for letting me fly the DeLorean, Doc. This thing's a blast.
Are you absolutely sure that everything's back to normal?
Totally. Kid's going to jail, Emmett's going to see Frankenstein, and there's no such thing as a Tannen crime family in 1986. And we remembered Einstein this time, too.
Hill Valley crime rate at all-time low.
Well, except for Grandpa necking with Trixie, I think we're ready to go back to 1986.
Do you feel yourself fading out of existence?
No.
Then as long as your father's still born in 7 years, I say, let your grandfather sow his oats.
Sowing oats? Is that what's going on with you and Edna?
What are you talking about?
Emmett and Edna, they're gonna go see Frankenstein together.
That's odd. God.
What?
We've got to get back in. This could be disastrous.
Stop! Where'd you go, Doc?
Relax! We've got everything under control.
Doc?
Martin McFly, age 18.
Okay, Doc, let's see what kind of nightmare alternate timeline I've landed in this time.
Father George, Mother Lorraine.
Hill Valley under Citizen Brown is not quite the contented town you were led to believe it was.
A re-education program? What the hell?
Please don't swear, Martin. It makes me uncomfortable.
Zero demerits until this morning.
We're through, McFly. I'll never date such a square again.
My own girlfriend thinks I'm a square?
The obvious question, Mr. McFly, is what happened to you?
Jesus Christ, Doc, what happened to you?